Hi friends, today we will see about cardiac autonomic neuropathy. It is frequent but an underdiagnosed complication of diabetes. It has a strong influence on various cardiac disorders including MI, hypertension, orthostatic hypotonia, heart failure, intraoperative cardiovascular instability and cardiac arrhythmias. It can lead to severe mortality and morbidity. This will increase the risk of sudden cardiac death as well. So let's see some more details. CAN, cardiac autonomic neuropathy, is a type of generalized systemic polyneuropathy. The autonomic nervous system has two major components, sympathetic and parasympathetic. These may operate independently or interact cooperatively to control heart rate, cardiac output, myocardial contractility, cardiac electrophysiology, and the constriction and dilatation of blood vessels. CAN is caused by damage to the autonomic nerve fibers which innervates to the heart and blood vessels and leads to the changes in the cardiovascular dynamics. Next we will see the pathogenesis of CAN.
CAN, cardiac autonomic neuropathy, is caused by complex interactions and involves several mechanisms and pathways that leads to neuronal ischemia, then finally neuronal death. The leading cause of pathogenic process is hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia induced oxidative stress and toxic advanced glycosylation products leads to changes in mitochondrial functions, membrane permeability, and endothelial functions. These different pathways induce disruption of several cellular functions and communication between the cells and surrounding matrix. All of this leads to neuronal dysfunction and death. CAN often first manifests in the vagus nerve, the body's longest parasympathetic autonomic nerve and the one responsible for almost 75% of parasympathetic activity. Damage to this vagus nerve causes resting tachycardia and overall decrease in parasympathetic tone. In the later stages of CAN, sympathetic denervation occurs starting from the apex to the base of the heart.
Let's see how the clinical manifestation of CAN. It includes resting tachycardia, postural hypotension, high intra or postoperative cardiovascular instability, more frequent asymptomatic MI, and high mortality rate after MI. Then how it is diagnosed? The diagnostic assessment should include testing of both sympathetic and vagal functions. The golden standards of tests known as cardiac autonomic reflex test, CARP, it involves measuring of autonomic changes through heart rate variability and BP with the various manoeuvres. And sympathetic function is assessed by BP response to the postural changes. Next we will see the classifications of CAN.
Classifications of cardiac autonomic neuropathy. Based on the diagnostic testings, CAN can be classified into three categories. The first one, early involvement. It means with one abnormal heart rate variability test or two or more borderline results. The second one, definite involvement with two or more abnormal results. The third one, severe involvement when orthostatic hypotension present. It can also be divided like clinical and subclinical. The first one, subclinic. It is based on the changes in the heart rate variability, baroreflex sensitivity, and cardiac images showing increased torsion of LV without any significant symptoms. The second one, clinical. It is diagnosed when sympathetic activity is predominant and symptoms such as decreased exercise tolerance, resting tachycardia, and orthostatic hypotension.
Next, we will look to the treatment, what we can do for this. Currently, the treatment of CAN is limited to the glycemic control to make the slow progression and symptomatic treatment for the orthostatic hypotension. Non-pharmacological management include physical maneuvers such as squatting and slow changes of the body posture, and lifestyle changes such as avoiding heavy carbohydrate meal and increase oral fluid intake. So let's wind up. So as we discussed, CAN, cardiac autonomic neuropathy, is a frequent chronic complication of diabetes with potentially life-threatening outcome. So the experts, they recommend screening of all diabetes patients because it has a significant negative influence on the coexisting cardiac disorders. I hope you enjoy my video. See you with the next classes. Bye bye.